whether you like it or not, he's back. Me and you and you down, still making songs, so on and so on. And I can go on and on and on and on and on. Hell yes, the world go round where it goes. Just don't go. Happy Friday, it is your boy Willie B. We got a female MC, her name is Boss, out of Detroit, Michigan. She got her master's degree at Wayne State University. She was a teacher of business education at Lewis College of Business. Her parents was deacons in the church, so she had a pretty structured upbringing. After graduating, she moved to California, LA. She started making music. She became friends with DJ Quick. He put her on a track with AMG. Russell Simmons got wind of her, and he liked her immediately. He was like, yo, I gotta sign her. He signed her to Def Jam West. 1993, they put out her debut album, which we're covering today, Born Gangsta. Production on here, it looks like they got a lot of great production. You know, you got Eric Sermon, Jam Master J, MC Search, a bunch of people.
You should take that off your answering machine. It does not sound nice. Coming from a young lady who was brought up through Catholic school for 12 years.
Intro is like her mother on her answer machine. You know, she's like a rapper now. She got degrees and shit. She's like, don't get caught out here trying to be a super gangster. Like, do know you got structure and you come from a good background.
Okay. I don't really wanna feel like I'm in a daze, so I smoke big pills just to deal with the ills. Life is fucked up, trip. Damn. My bills ain't paying bills and it's fucking with me in my grip.
This is one of my favorite California old school vibes, yo. Like, anytime I hear this beat, I'm mesmerized. Compton's Most Wanted did this beat too. This is like low music, bro. Yo, she is not holding no punches back. Her flow is butter.
I'm coming to get you tonight when you sleep. Creeping steady but quick. I'm here to tell you. And being a bad bitch, you run up, you get stuck. What was going through your mind when you're caught over boss? You could ever fuck.
Like, she's really just sounding like the gangsta ass bitch that's just in the crew. Just, you know, rock-a-bye, baby. Like the chick from New Jack City who just shoot at will, who drink 40s all day but don't get fat.
Yeah, back again and again and again. It's a boss damn rock in the mood. I feel like fucking with a nigga tonight. And can't no motherfucker slow me down, hold me down. No, if I was you, I wouldn't fuck around.
I'm just thinking of, like, dating her. Like, if she's my girlfriend, I'm like, oh, baby, you going to go do gangster shit today? Like, I'm going to my little 9-to-5. She's just like... I'm like, all right, baby, have a nice day. I'll be here when you get home. If you get home.
5B10 Pass Alameda, George, on Mary 541, George, on Mary 541.
It's a quarter to 12, and I'm chilling with a club brew. Thinking about some devilish shit that I'm down to do. But just before it hit, shit got hot. Just down my block.
She was out there in Compton in early 90s and shit. So she definitely, they made that drive-by culture shit out there. That was not East Coast gangsters did not produce that. That was all West Coast gangsters. They always took it too far.
Who am I to flip a wicked bitch? Business is business, but I'm the revelation that you need without a boss. Bitch is trying to get rich and doing a good job and ripping up the page.
She used one of my favorite samples, that doom, 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 doom. The only other person I heard use it was Action Bronson. The transitions in this is perfect for her because she could switch that flow up. She could sound like fucking Ice Cube for a second. Then she sound like my fucking JD and Criss Cross and them niggas. And then, you know, she just got so many flavors going on. Bro, she killing this motherfucking shit. I ain't never heard Process of Elimination, but she eliminate niggas on this joint, bro.
What the fuck is up, bitch? Where the fuck you been at, man? Yo, man, where is more niggas in here be fighting? Niggas make up that old bullshit. Well, look, man, fuck it. You know what I'm saying? Yo, I'm a fucking sticky fucking dingus.
Bro, I'm just so shocked that her subject matter is like, so gangster. Like, she is really the chick in the set. I think that's really what she became when she came to LA. She was just, they accepted her and she just started drinking 40s and smoking weed. They put a motherfucking bulletproof vest on her ass. They turned her into Tupac.
Guess who? The down ass bitch. Thinking on how your dick could be getting shot. Little fuck off. The dick keep
like she's trying too hard to be hard on this shit. It's like, you don't need to be that hard on this song. It's like, this is her tempo, yo. Like, she's on that run, you know, shoot him up, kill him, get him, you know what I mean, type of tempo, dog. Like, I love her on that shit. She know what she doing.
August 14th, 1969, I wish this child was born to be a threat to the humankind. See, I'm the bitch that niggas read about, cause I won't hesitate to blow your motherfucking brains out.
Got her on some old pimp Cadillac music type shit on here. They actually kind of giving her a unique sound.
Pull up on body bags. You clip them, we zip them. Okay, I got it. You clip them, we zip them. Body bags. Pull up on body bags.
Shit gets deep, but in the beginning, life was even worse. When I saw the shell of my mother's soul, it lost in the back of my...
If you were ever listening to Boss and wonder what went wrong, baby girl, she's explaining it right here. She like, yeah, I got jumped into this gang and I started doing a whole bunch of hood rat shit with my friends. And one thing led to another. She in her like salt and pepper bag right here. She just keeps switching it up. You know, this one is a little more mid to me. And she do not give any fucks. She has no more fucks to give. No more in stock. I try to leave the house with a decent amount of fucks. Because I don't want to run out of fucks to give. This bitch leaves out the house negative fucks to give. She's like, if you got any fucks to spare, don't give them to me. So this album scored a 55, which is a good album, man. Surprising album too. Like, a lot of really good moments in this. And she is a motherfucking gangster artist. She played her role well, I would say that. Her theme is like the shooter, the crazy loco chick who they just like spring out on motherfuckers when shit get crazy. So I like that she really embodied it. It's some quintessential hip-hop records on here that you cannot deny. Shout out to Boss, man. She killed this shit. Make sure y'all go get laced up. Daybox did it. He did it again. You can also check this out over at blessedteens.com. All right, man. That's it for me.